Yes, class. In the previous class, we have completed the misadventure which took place at the swimming pool, where William Douglas, even he did not know how to swim. He was thrown by a boy, and later on, he was almost buried under the water. He was drowned in the swimming pool. Reason, he did not know how to swim and he was at the deep end, 9 feet deep. When he realized that mind was working, he made some plan. And what was the plan? That he would take a jump from the bottom and then he will come to the surface of the water. Then he will lie down, and after being lie down, he would swim to the edge. But he tried twice, and both the experience or both the efforts were failure. He could not come out of the water. And then he realized that this is the time when he must go for death. He accepted his approaching death. Then he saw himself as the angel of God was carrying him. And they were the tender arms, very adorable arms, loving arms, just like mother. Then he forgot everything. He thought that the life was completely down. The curtain of life fell. Till here we have completed in previous class. So now we are starting the next one. The next, I remember I was lying on my stomach beside the pool vomiting. It is clear now that the person, that William Douglas was saved. Okay, the next I remember, William Douglas remembered that he was on the stomach and he was lying by the pool and he was vomiting. Vomiting for what? Because somebody was taking out the water by pressing the stomach. Somebody was taking out the water from the stomach. That was the vomiting. He was doing vomiting. The chap, the boy that threw me in was saying, the same boy, bully boy, who threw him into the swimming pool. He was saying, but I was only fooling, that it was just for a fun. He was making some fun. We all know it was not the intention of the boy that the child must die. It was just only for fun. So somebody sat there, the kid nearly died. The kid was just about to die, but he was saved now. Be all right now. Let's carry him to the locker room. Then they all, the people who were taking care of the child at that time, they took him to the locker room so that he could change the clothes. Several hours later, after some time, some hour, I walked home. He was now coming back to home. But I was weak. He was very weak there at that moment, and trembling, and he was also trembling, shivering. I shook and cried when I lay on my bed. Whenever he went to the bed, he started to shiver and he cried because of fear. Everything, his mind started to muddle up. The thoughts came into his mind as he was under the water. On that day, he couldn't eat. That night, he was unable to take the meal because still at that moment he was becoming drowsy. For days, a haunting fear was in my heart. For many days, he could feel the fear in his heart. He was thinking as the heart was really scaring for him because of the fear. The slightest exertion upset me. Even if any single mark, single point he realized, he became very upset. And this thought made him wobbly in the knees. Knee become weak. They could not control the body. and said to my stomach, and stomach, it felt that still the water was inside the stomach. It is becoming sick. I never went to the pool. And after that incident, it was a horrible incident for William Douglas. William Douglas, he had taken now two misadventures. First, when he was of 3 or 4 years old at California Beach. After 6-7 years, he was determined a little bit so that he could go for swimming. Later on, when he went to the swimming pool, this misadventure took place. And because of that, it was a horrible moment for him. So he could not come out of that. So whenever he went to pool, the fear came into him. That's why he did not go. He never went. Whenever he thought to go to the pool, he was scared. So he never went. I feared water. He started to fear of water. I avoided it whenever I could. And he tried not to go to the water. Water means water bodies like river, lakes. He never went there if he could resist. A few years later, after some year, once again, when I came to know the waters of Cascades, he realized that there is a place, Cascades, and there are some lakes. He wanted to get into them, he wanted to go there. But problem was, and whenever I did, whenever he tried to go there, whenever he went there, whether I was wading the tidal or bumping river or bathing in the warm lake of the God Rocks, whenever he went either at the tidal or river or some warm lake at the God Rocks, whenever he reached to these lakes, the terror, it once again back to him that had seized me in the pool would come back. The terror which he realized at swimming pool, YMCA pool, it was the problem for him. The terror what he experienced, it was always back to him. So he could not go to the lakes where he could think of bathing or swimming. It would take possession of me completely, the terror. The terror possessed him, terror overtake him. And that's why he could not go. My legs would become paralyzed. Whenever he go there, his legs, they become paralyzed, senseless. Icy horror would grab my heart, and the fear, it came into his heart. This handicap stayed with me as the years rolled by. For many years, he experienced the same horror, same drawbacks. He could not go to the swimming pool or any place which is related to water. In canoes, on main lakes, fishing for land salmon, these are the places where he wanted to go, but he could not go. Main lakes fishing for landlocked salmon, he could not go there. Next is bass fishing. These are the fish's name. Bass is the fish, and just after a few words, there is trout, it is fish. So he could not go there. Bass fishing in New Hampshire, he could not go there. Trout fishing on the deserts, he could not go there. Medalists in Oregon, he could not go to Oregon to hunt or to hunt medalist fisher. Fishing for salmon on Columbia at bumping lakes in Cascades means at any place where there are lakes or rivers, he could not go there. Okay. So here, wherever I went, whenever he thought that he must go and where he wanted to try, the haunting fear of the water followed me. The same fear he experienced at the swimming pool, the same fear came to him at each and every time whenever he went to any river or any lake for either fishing, for either swimming or for bathing. He could not go there. It ruined my fishing trips. Because of that fear, he could not go even for fishing. Deprived me of the joy of canoeing, boating and swimming. Because of the fear, he could not enjoy canoeing, boating, swimming. It means this is the effect of this misadventure. This question has been asked 3 or 4 times in your question paper, that what was the effect of the misadventure of swimming pool on William Douglas. Okay, so the whole paragraph we can say, just see from the back here, this handicap stayed me. From here, that he could not go to many lakes for fishing, like Main Lakes, Landlocked Salmon, and the next one is Bass Fishing, Hampshire, Trout Fishing, Deserts, Metallus, Oregon. He could not go there. And as well as, he was unable to do the canoeing, boating, and swimming. Means, he had to lose all water sports. Clear? This would be your answer. What was the impact of misadventure? The effect of misadventure that he had to forget all the sports related to water, like canoeing, boating, swimming, fishing, etc. Now, this from here, the most important part of the lesson starts. Okay, see here, I used every way I knew to overcome this fear. He tried many ways so that he could get rid of this fear. But it held me firmly in its grip. But the fear was not ready to leave him. Finally, 1 October. Now, you must listen carefully. Now, 1 October, I decided to get an instructor and learn to swim. This is the most important part, and the most important question will come here. Okay, I decided to get an instructor and learn to swim. Finally, in 1 October, he thought that he must hire an instructor to learn swimming. So I went to a pool. He went to a pool and practiced 5 days a week. Make it underline in your book. Okay. I went to pool, practiced 5 days a week, an hour each day. The instructor, the class, was for 5 days a week, an hour per day. The instructor put belt around me. He just tied up a belt on the waist of, around the waist of William Douglas. A rope attached to the belt went through a pulley that ran on an overhead cable. He was in the swimming pool and a rope was attached to the belt and it was going down, going up at the top of the swimming pool. Over the swimming pool there was a rope and there was a pulley, a wheel was there. So the rope, it was going from the belt of William Douglas to that pulley, to that wheel, and the second edge of that rope was in the hand of instructor. He held on to the end of rope and we went back and forth and he started floating. If you have gone to learn how to swim, you must know that floating is first exercise. Okay, float on the water. So he went back and forth across the pool. Hour after hour, day after day, we know that in one day nobody is going to be a master. You must realize here, in one day nobody is going to be perfect, either you or me, nobody. So he took the class for many days, hour after hour, day after day, week after week, many weeks he passed just only for floating. On each trip across the pool, a bit of the panic seized me. But whenever he went into the pool for floating, sometimes the pain came back to him, the fear came back to him, and he was seized. He could not move. Each time the instructor relaxed his hold on the rope and I went under. Some of the old terror returned and my legs froze. It is just like that. In your childhood, when you learn how to ride a cycle, your parents or your brother, sister, elder, they hold the cycle from the back. Okay, and when you start pedaling, sometimes they leave that so that you can start how to control on cycle. In the same way, the instructor was teaching him how to face the water when we are under the water. So whenever he was in the pool, the teacher gave some relaxation at the rope and he went down. So he started fear, little fear. And it was 3 months before the tensions began to slip. He took 3 months. Okay, he took 3 months. And after 3 months, the fear started to be weak or less. Then the teacher taught him to put my face under water and exhale. Then William Douglas learned how to exhale and how to inhale. A swimmer should exhale when he is under the water. But to take the breath, his nose must be out of the water. He learned inhaling and exhaling. I repeated the exercise hundreds of times. He did this for many days. But bit by bit, I shed part of the panic that seized me when my head went under water. But sometimes he felt some fear, but because he was doing many times the same exercise, the fear, it was flying away. Is that clear? The fear was becoming weak or less. Now he was not feared of water when he put his head under the water. Next, he held me at the side of the pool. Okay, now he was at the edge of the pool and had me kick with my legs, and he was taught how to kick the legs in the water. When we swim, we kick the water. 4 weeks I did just that. For many weeks he did only kicking. At first my legs refused to work because they felt paralyzed because of the fear, but they gradually relaxed. But after some time, the legs were also started to work, and finally I could command them. Now the legs were under the command of William Douglas. Now see the most important line. Thus, by piece, he built a swimmer. Okay, it means the instructor taught him in pieces. Now I am coming back to the passage where we started how to learn swimming here. Is that clear? Finally, 1 October. So from here till the last, piece by piece here. Okay, the one question is this: how did he learn how to swim, or how did the instructor teach him the swimming? Is that clear? This question has been asked at least 4 or 5 times. Maximum time this question has been asked in your question paper from this lesson. That how did he learn swimming, or how did the teacher, instructor, teach him how to swim, or how did the teacher made him a swimmer? Is that clear? So in that way, piece by piece, because he taught him piece by piece. First he taught floating, then he taught inhaling, exhaling, then kicking the legs, then moving the hands, etc. Everything is not here, but we can understand. He built a swimmer. Let's continue now. When he had perfected each piece, when he taught me each and every piece, each and every part of swimming, he put them together into an integrated whole. And he told that now this is the time when he should use all the exercise at once. In April, from October to April, around 6 months have been passed. And in April he said, now you can swim. This is the time that he could swim, dive off and swim the length of the pool, crawl stroke. This is a type of swimming, crawling. It means after 6 months of learning, the instructor told him to cross the length of the pool by swimming. And I did. William Douglas swam. Is it clear? William Douglas followed the instruction of instructor and he swam. Now once again, underline these two lines. The instructor was finished, but I was not finished. Okay? Why did William Douglas told these lines? Or what is the impact of these lines? The instructor was finished. What is the work of a teacher or instructor? The instructor work is to guide you, to help you, to understand you, to make you understand. It means the teacher can help you in the preparation only. Just like this one, you can say from your, you can take an example from your life. The teacher can teach you for 1 year, whole year, but in the examination you have to face the exam. No teacher is going to help you. It happens the same way. The instructor has taught him for 6 months how to swim. He had taught him each and every actions, each and every technique. He had made him swimmer. But I was not finished. But he was not finished. It means his work was not completed. Why? Until he was not going to appear in the examination, he was not going to be confident. It's simply in any class, either it's math, physics, chemistry, accounts, any class, when teacher teaches you, you learn how to solve the question. But when you can be confident only at one time, when you did the question by yourself, because you got confidence that now we can do. If you do 2-3 questions, then confidence occurs that now these questions are easy, we can move to the next. The same feeling is here of William Douglas. William Douglas taught, he told that instructor's work was completed. He had taught him how to swim completely, but I was not finished. But now this is the test of William Douglas that he could swim or not. I still wondered if I would be terror stricken. Next line is clear here, making our discussion clear. I still wondered, he was surprised, or he was with some questions, if I would be terror stricken when I was alone in the pool. Till now there was an instructor to help him. But now he was thinking that if he is alone in the pool, would the terror be back? And I tried it. He made some attempts. I swam the length up and down. He took a journey in the swimming pool. and he swam to the length of the pool. He went forth, forward and back. Tiny vestiges of the old terror would return. The terror returned, but it was very small, in very small part. But now I could frown and say to that terror, "Trying to scare me." But this shows his determination, his confidence. But now I could frown. He could make a fun of that. He could fly away the terror by saying, "Okay, you are trying to scare me. You are trying to fear me. Ah, here's to you. Then look. Now I am not going to afraid. Look, and off I would go for another length of the pool. Whenever a little fear came to him, he once again tried to swim, and he swam." It means he was determined, he was courageous. We discussed the values before starting the lesson. He was courageous, he was determined here, he was resolute. Okay, his willpower, well planning, these all things made him successful in his attempt. This went on until July. For next 3 months, around 3-4 months, he did swimming in the swimming pool. But I was still not satisfied. But he was not satisfied. It means the complete confidence did not come to him. I wasn't sure that all the terror had left. Clear? That he was not sure that terror has gone. Because swimming pool was a safe place. But the rivers and lakes, they are not as safe as swimming pool. So I went to lake. वो लेक में जाता है, Wentworth in New Hampshire. Where he wanted to go earlier, now he is going. Wentworth in Hampshire, he went there. Dived off a dock at Trigg's Island and swam 2 miles across the lake to Stamford Island. These are the places where he did swimming. You have to learn here. Question has been asked once only, not many times. This one, why did he go to Wentworth in New Hampshire? And the second one is Trigg's Island. Yeah, this one. Dive off. Why did he go to Trigg's Island? Actually, he wanted to get the complete confidence. That's why he went there. He had some doubt that could he swim there alone? And he swam there for 2 miles. And I swam the crawl, breaststroke, side stroke, backstroke. He did all type of swimming there. These are the types of swimming. Only once did the terror return. But once, the terror was back to him. When I was in the middle of the lake, when he was in the middle of the lake, I put my face under and saw nothing but bottomless water. Because swimming pool, it is just only 9-10 feet deep, but lakes are 90 or 100 or more than 100 feet deep. So the bottom is not visible. When he put his face under the water, he could see only bottomless water. The old sensation returned in miniature. The old terror sensations, the same feelings he experienced at swimming pool. They came in very short amount, miniature, very short amount, and I laughed. But this time, because he was much confident, he was determined also, but most importantly, confident. He laughed at the terror and said, "Well, Mr. Terror, what do you think you can do to me? Then what you can do now?" And it fled. When he made fun of terror, terror fled. Terror fly away, and I swam, and he continued his swim. Yet I had residual doubts. Still he had many doubts, some very small doubts. So at my first opportunity, I hurried west. He went to the west side, went up to Titan, to Conard Meadows, up the Conard Creek trails, to Mid Glaciers, and camped in High Meadows by the side of Warm Lake. These all are the places where he went to encourage the confidence in him, where he wanted to go earlier. Okay, he put the tent, and next day I stripped. He was once again ready to jump, dive into the lake, and swam across to the other shore and back. He crossed the lake and came back, just as Doc Corporal used to do earlier. Mr. Doc Corporal, he had done it. In the same way, he swam the lake and he became successful. So I shouted with joy. He was very happy because he had overcome his fear. And Gilbert Peak returned the echo. When he shouted, there was a peak, Gilbert Peak. The echo sound came back to him. I had conquered my fear of water. He had conquered the fear. Is it? He had won over the water. The experience had a deep meaning for me, as only those who have known stark terror and conquered it can appreciate. The experience, it was very fruitful to him, and it has a deep meaning. And only those people who had faced the terror and who had overcome the terror, they can understand not the feelings of William Douglas. In death, there is peace. Listen to this carefully. In death, there is peace. Death is not horrible. It provides us peace. There is terror only in the fear of death. Terror is there only fear of death. As Roosevelt knew when he said, the President Roosevelt, all we have to fear is fear itself. That means fear is only a word. We have only one thing which should be feared. That is the fear. Our fear should be feared of. Is that clear? Means we should not fear. Our fear should be feared of our courage, our determination, our dedication. Because I had experienced both the sensation of dying and old terror that fear of it can produce. He had experienced the sensation of dying in swimming pool, and now the fear, he had come over. The will to live somehow grew in intensity. Definitely, now the fear which he was feared of, he could take that away from him. It was from the intensity. It was from the willpower, from him. At last, I felt released. Now he was relaxed, free to walk the trails and climb the peaks and to brush aside. Now, William Douglas was busy to remove other fears, to go to peaks, to go to some other lakes. Whatever fear he had, now he was able to remove that fear. By how? Just only by courage, by determination, by dedication, and by willpower. These four or five values must be learned to you in this lesson. Is that clear?